Okay, so dear all, now we start our lecture. Our today's topic is insect head. Here in this topic, we have to study about the different sclerite, structure of insect head, and even suture that comes under in insect head, and other different mouth parts that we'll discuss on in today's lecture. So first of all, so you all that you know well that about the insect body that which covered with a hard chitinous exoskeleton that already we learned in arthropodan characters, even class insecta. So where we studied these all characters. So the body is covered with the chitin or made up of chitin and is called as this exoskeleton, or we can say in other hand that cuticle. Why this exoskeleton and chitin were present? Because of which gives the protection from different mechanical injury. Even also not given only the protection, even also it protects to loss of or to prevent the loss of excess moisture of from insect body. So this all that body that may be the different segmented, isn't it? And this all segmented or that series of, or that means the segmentation series or the composed of series of successive rings, isn't it? So these all successive rings, which is called as segments. Listen now what I'm talking. Tala segments sudha mantat, even it is called as a metameres sudha mantat, metameres. Now I'm talking the different word. Again, the third word here, that to segment, metameres, and also called as somites. So for you, you all remember this, the insect body segmented and which is made up of or composed of series of successive rings. That means there is the segmentation occur, that all that successive rings, which is called as segments also, metameres also, and somites also. So these all are important for insect body. Now the today's topic is insect head. So insect head, which is formed by, wait, I'm just to highlight. Okay, so insect head, which is formed by or fusion of six segments. Okay, it is formed by the insect head, which is formed due to the fusion of six segments. This is very important for objective. Head is made up of fill in the blanks, the segments, and which plus acron. Forget this acron, because this acron not comes under our syllabus, not given also. So you just to remember the head, which is formed by or fusion of six segments along with different appendages in head, which are these. Mouth parts is there, pair of antenna is there, pair of compound is there, three ocelli is there, isn't it? In mouth parts, various segments also, isn't it? So these all are that present in insect head. Why these all appendages are important? Because it is mostly concerned with the feeding mechanism, even also that carries special sensory organ like antennae and eyes. So that purpose, the insect head is very, very important for insect body, isn't it? Now, which are the segments were present in insect head? First of all, the name of segment is that pre-antennary segment, antennary segment, intercalary segment, mandibular segment, maxillary segment, and lastly that is labial segment. These are the major segment were present in insect head. Now look at this. In insect body, these appendages or these segments that the bears or that responsible to form the various appendages. Segments are different, appendages are different. Try to understand it. First of all, segments means these are the series, or these are the series of segments or metameres or somites. that responsible to made or to that to participate to forming the head. And this again, these segments are to form various appendages. Barabar. For example, jaisa ki apni body hai. अपनी बॉडी एक है पर हमारे बॉडी को भी अदर अपेंडेजेस है, हैंड्स है, लेग्स है, इजंट इट, सो दिस ऑल दैट इवन आईज है, सो हेयर्स है, दिस आर ऑल दैट रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर दिस फुलफिलनेस ऑफ दिस होल बॉडी. सो हियर इन हेड टू फॉर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस हेड दिस सेगमेंट आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल और टू फॉर्म वेरियस अपेंडेजेस. सो अमंग दिस ऑल, सो विच ऑफ दिस इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर exam point of view and for the general information point of view, you try to understand. First of all, pre-antennary segment, which is responsible to form compound eyes, pre-antennary segment that bears or to form this compound eyes. Antennary is very simple, that responsible, that antennae, isn't it? That antennae is formed. Intercalary is very important, that is the it's a labrum, that is a upper lip of insect head, that's to form by the segment intercalary. Mandibular is easy because it's a teeth of insect, that formation of mandibles. Now maxillarily, it is also the second jaw, second teeth of insect body. And lastly, labium, that is a labial, that is lower lip, that formation of labium. So these are the segments and appendages that comes under in the head region of insect body. So now these are very important for you all, that student, first of all I cleared you those topic we learn in theory, and same this all topic also comes under in our practical also, isn't it? So don't be confused that the practical are different and the theory is different. No, our syllabus is same. Those topic you learn in theory also, you just to write in your practical. So just our practical compilation also now finish, and we'll send today or tomorrow. Okay, so don't worry about that. This is the second exercise of our practical, and for examination also, theory examination point of view also very important. Now the which are the sclerites that comes under a head capsule. Now which are the sclerites? First of all, here these many sclerites that comes under in head capsule. First of all, I am that enlisting that vertex. This is one epicranium or vertex, frons, clypeus, labrum, genu, occiput, and then lastly post occiput. This is the total sclerite that present in insect head. First of all, this all that appendages are antenna, mandibles, and maxillae. Okay, so here like some sulcus, that means the sclerites were present. So sclerites means what? Which is the correspond to internal strengthening purpose ridge like that called as sulcus. That is a hard sclerite, hard, that is compact, and even the sclerotized part of forming this complete head, where this all that composed of several sclerite and which is associated that to form a hard compact head, and which is also called as head capsule. And here inside this all sclerites are articulated or that to present inside the head region or head capsule, isn't it? So this head region, what is mean by firstly epicranium means what? Firstly, I'm talking about epicranium here, not mentioned, but before vertex the first sclerite is epicranium. Epicranium means what? Try to understand this figure. Now I am showing you this all this figure, this part mark, jo mark kar raha hu aapko dikh raha hai.
Yes sir.
So now this complete part, this called as epicranial part, epicranium. Cranium you know well. Okay, epicranium means epi means upper, above. So it is the dorsal region. Are you clear that the dorsal region ventral region, then lateral region. Yes or no? First of all, clear it. What is mean by dorsal region? Anyone side. Try to give answer?
Lower side.
Yes, yes, yes. Dorsal region means what?
Backside.
Backside.
Dorsal means what? Backside means what?
Posterior.
Posterior means what? Posterior means last. Lower. Insect have. Lower. Now I'm clearing.
Vertex.
The insect body segment generally is a divisible or divide into four region. How many region? Four regions or four sides. First clear. First one, just to take your hand and just to observe upper part that is called as the dorsal region or dorsum is called as also dorsum or tergum part. Tergum, dorsum, dorsal. Understood? Uppermost part of insect body known as dorsal, dorsum, tergum. Again, I am repeat. Dorsal, dorsum, S-U-M. Dorsum, D-O-R-S-U-M. And or tergum, T. E R G U M, tergum. Okay, this is the first. Now the lower part, that is called as the ventral part, ventral region, lowermost part of insect body, lower part. Khalchi baju apan tyala mhanto ventral region, which is called as sternum. S T E R N U M, sternum. Now, which sides now remain? Upper, lower, then which side remain now?
Lateral.
Now, how many lateral side? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Two lateral side.
Cleared? Two region, four regions. That means the lastly, two lateral regions and are known as pleuron. What is called? Pleuron. P-L-U-R-O-N. Pleuron or plural. Pluri or plural. Isn't it? So this is the reason. Now let's come our main topic. Firstly, epicranium part. This epicranium part means what? This hole that I marked on that figure. So here, this is the epicranium part. Epicranium means it is upper. It is upper or lower? It is uppermost part. Also called as the dorsal region of the head. And which is lying, or now just to try to observe, which is lying or which is located in between and behind the AKI. What is this? I am marking on that.
Compound eye.
Understood? Epicranium where located? It is a dorsal region or uppermost part of insect head capsule, which is lying or located in between or behind the compound eyes. Understood? First one. Now, it's a region from this epicranium part, that is the area. Epicranium ka area kahan se kahan tak hai, which is extending up to. यहां से अगर जस्ट टू यू टेक ऑब्जर्वेशन फ्रॉम यहां से फ्रॉम दी लास्ट अप टू नेक दिस इज नेक सो इट विच इज एक्सटेंडिंग फ्रॉम दी अप टू दी नेक रीजन विच इज एक्सटेंडिंग फ्रॉम अप टू दी नेक रीजन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इपिक्रैनियम ओके इपिक्रैनियम हियर कंप्लीट नाउ वर्टेक्स Now the second part, second sclerite vertex. Vertex means what? It is also the part of. किसका part होगा फिर? जल आपन आपने जल हाँ?
Epicranium.
Yes, it is a part of or it is a portion of epicranium, which is also lies or that located behind this part. इसके बारे में बता आपको पता करना होना जरूरी है. It is lying behind the fronds and between the compound eyes. बिटवीन एंड बिहाइंड दी फ्रॉन्स, फ्रॉन्स के पीछे वाला, और इन बिटवीन में कंपाउंड आइज में, दैट इज अ वर्टेक्स. वर्टेक्स मीन्स वॉट? इट इज ऑल्सो पोर्शन और इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ इपिक्रैनियम विच इज लाइज बिहाइंड दी फ्रॉन्स रीजन एंड बिटवीन दी कंपाउंड आइज, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वर्टेक्स. नाउ लेट्स सी इन द थर्ड वन, दैट इज अ फ्रॉन्स, दैट इज अ फ्रॉन्स. Now fronds region, this one fronds. Okay, fronds means what? Now let's see in detail first this one. यहाँ से आपको बताता हूँ fronds क्या है. अभी देखो ये पूरा complete view है. Yes or no? That is a we can say anterior view or face view, facial view. Okay. So here this fronds, it is the upper facial part. This one facial part है. This is the upper facial part of insect head, which is dorsal to clypeus and laterally by fronto. Okay, forget this all that like fronto like clypeal like that. Just to fronts. Fronts means it is a facial part of head capsule and which is lying just below the arms of epicranial suture. यहाँ पे जो इपिक्रैनियल सूचक के जो आर्म्स है दिस वन, सो यहाँ पे इसका लोकेटेड है फ्रॉन्स में, विच इज फेसियल पार्ट एंड विच इज लाइज जस्ट लाइक बिलो लाइंग बिटवीन द आर्म्स ऑफ इपिक्रैनियम. इपिक्रैनियम वेयर टू सिंपल आइज, वेयर टू और थ्री सिंपल आइज, वन टू थ्री, वहां पे है टू और थ्री सिंपल आइज आर सिचुएटेड above the anterior arms of epicranium in the vertex region, in the vertex region. Maybe in your notes also the different language, but there also they very easy, but what I am that talking you, so it's a different references books that we I read out, so that's I'm trying to give the best for you all. Okay, fronts means what? Which is the facial part and which is where this located, just lying below that between the epicranium suture, where the two arms of epicranial suture and where the two or three simple eyes means oscilli were situated, isn't it? That in the vertex region, that is called as this fronts. Now again we turn to our main, that is what is mean by clypeus. This is one clypeus, this one clypeus. And this clypeus is nothing but it is a one small broad plate like structure and which is lies immediately anterior to the fronts. Iske anterior jo part hai fronts ka, which is anterior part of this fronts, isn't it? And it is a broad and partially free plate. A broad hai aur which is partially free plate hai, that is called as clypeus. Okay, that means the clypeus here complete. Now labrum, labrum which is the lowermost anterior part of insect head, a lowermost anterior part of insect head which forms the upper lip, that is the responsible part to upper lip, which is mohable, a mohable and which is helpful for the feeding and other purpose, isn't it? And where that to articulate it along with the clypeus, इसका joint है, इसका joining है to the clypeus, that is known as the labrum. So student, this is overall, this all that the anterior point of view, this sclerites of insect head. Now let's see in lateral view. Okay, sorry, lateral view means back side. That is firstly, that's jejuna, that is jejuna. Jejuna means what? It is a lateral, this one lateral side or cheek region, that is called as a jejuna. Ye dekho, okay, lateral side or cheek region. Abhi iska location just below and behind the compound eyes, behind the compound eye, just below the compound eye, that is called as the jejuna. Okay, so which important for, what is the role of this jejuna? Which is bears a mouth cavity, which bears a mouth cavity and where this mandibular condyle, this mandibular condyle were articulated inside this genal region, genal sclerite. जहाँ पे जेनस क्लेराइट है वहां पे मैंडिबुलर जिस मैंडिबुल है इनसे के टीथ है वहां पे उसका आर्टिकुलेशन मींस जॉइंट वेयर इन जेनल रीजन दैट इज अ जेना दैट इज अ लैटरल साइड. नाउ ऑक्सीपुट, नाउ लेट्स सी इन डिटेल अबाउट द ऑक्सीपुट मींस व्हाट. इट इज ए हाइंडर पार्ट और लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ इंसेक्ट हेड, हाइंडर पार्ट ऑफ इंसेक्ट हेड दैट इज ऑक्सीपुट. Okay, and this occiput, which is a part of also the epicranium, under part of this insect head and also the part of epicranium, isn't it? And lying in between, कहाँ पे उसका location है, situated है, इसका main location है, in between the vertex, in between the vertex and complete यहाँ पे जो cervix आता है और तो neck आता है, neck के बीच में. नेक और सर्विस के बीच में ऑक्सीप्यूट सिचुएटेड है और लोकेटेड है विच इज हाइंडर पार्ट ऑफ द इंसेक्ट हेड एंड ऑल्सो द पार्ट ऑफ इपिक्रैनियम विच इज लाइंग और लोकेटेड इन बिटवीन वर्टेक्स एंड सर्विक्स और नेक रीजन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ए ऑक्सीप्यूट. नाउ लेट्स सी इन डिटेल अबाउट द लास्ट स्क्लेराइट पोस्ट ऑक्सीप्यूट. पोस्ट ऑक्सीप्यूट मीन्स वॉट. इट इज ऑल्सो द वन रीजन ऑफ इंसेक्ट हेड कैप्सूल which is lying or located in between where try to give answer. Post occiput ye jo post occiput hai kahan pe located hoga
in between occiput.
Yes, in between the occiput and neck region. It is a region of head capsule which is lying in between the occiput and neck region and which in which the neck membrane were attached. Neck membrane for why? Why this neck membrane which is important for this insect head where there is the presence of one cervical membrane, cervix or neck. Apan tala man manto apli barobar na cervix or neck. So in between there is the one membrane, the name membrane known as cervical membrane, isn't it? So where that thorax and head, there is a thorax and head and in between there is the one organ known as a neck and this for the connection purpose or joint purpose, connected purpose, one membranous part were present that is called as a cervical membrane which gives the flexibility even also to allows or to giving the movement of head purpose. So this cervical membrane were important. So student, this is all are the different sclerites of insect head and which is very important for us for practical even also your theory examination point of view. Now let's see, this is also the same those I am talking about, just I said you all are the information. Again I am not repeating vertex means what here in simple language here given dorsal side uppermost part and which is responsible that to gives the oscilli and antenna that on the vertex region frons which is anterior face or facial part where the oscillus is located on it because in the arms of epicranium suture where the two or three oscilli they are present. Clypeus means what? It is a tip like broad plate like structure and which is attached to the frons to the anteriorly. And labrum means it is also called as the lowermost part of insect head capsule and which is also called as upper lip and which is freely movable. Just to imagine agar labrum agar freely movable nahi hota, so it's possible the insect that feed on food ek just to take observation agar aapke lips okay agar awesome. Aapke lips human being ke lips agar freely movable nahi hote can you feed? Can we feed?
No, sir.
Yes.
No, sir. It is impossible.
Impossible. Why? Again, you take imagination. You don't have lip. Then, आपको अगर if in humans and other animals that absence of lip, how it looks?
Very bad.
Very bad. Even also, it's not cover the our mouth cavity, mouth parts, isn't it? That have the several reason. So we'll see in detail in our mouth parts when we'll study onwards lecture. So that time I will explain this all. Now the jena again, lateral side, cheek region, galacha bhag manto apan tyala. Okay, it is the lowermost part of the insect head, that which is beneath the eyes or below or behind the eyes. Okay, and which is responsible where that the mandibular, that condyle were articulated. Occiput, that is a hinder part of epicranium or head region, which comprises most of the back of the head. And here that the occipital suture divides, it forms the vertex and jeni. Post occiput, it is also the one margin where the occipital foramen and narrow ling like structure in shape, and where the post occipital suture divides, it forms a occiput. This is overall the sclerite regarding this head capsule. Now let's see in detail about this different suture. Okay, so now next one, the sutures of insect head, same like sulcus or sclerite we learned. Now the suture, in suture that epicranial suture, that the frontoclypeal suture, clypeolabral suture, genal suture, subgenal suture, and occipital suture, post occipital suture. Remember one thing, in between the two sclerite one narrow plate like ring like membrane structure, that which is important to connect it of both sclerite, that is called as the suture, isn't it? So this all are the important for, so I'm not explaining this all because the suture is a very simple, because this those sclerites that join together with the help of the narrow plate like structure, this plate like structure known as a suture. Suppose in case the sulcus or the sclerites lies between the frons and clypeus. Okay, frons and clypeus. Epicranial suture means what? Where the sulcus or sclerite present in between, or plate membrane present in between the vertex and epicranium. That is epicranium. Clypeolabral suture, that is the sulcus or suture sclerite which is located between the clypeus and labrum. That is clypeolabral. Subgenal, lateral extension, even epistemol. And even also that sulcus just lies just above the mandibles. Okay, like those are sclerites that's present, and this plate membrane were present. Okay, that is called as the, so this not important, but to remember for the joining of two sclerite, those plates like structure or membrane were present in between the two sclerite called as suture. Okay, these are all that suture, and among this all, this which is the true suture will ask in exam, among which is the in insect head capsule. Remember all, in head capsule, inside the head, insect body, which is the true suture or real suture? It is nothing but it's a post occipital suture. Why? Where there is a presence of, it is a groove running across the back of the head and behind the compound eyes, and where it is located in between the vertex, and even also that it is present in between the occiput and neck region. That is called as the post occipital suture, and which is known as a real suture. Here I mentioned the of all suture, which is only the real suture, is a post occipital suture, is a real suture. Among these all will ask in exam, which of the suture is a real suture. Okay, so remember all of you, it is the most occipital suture is very, why, which is responsible to separating maxillary and labial segment, that lowermost jaw, that is maxilla, and lowermost that lip, that is a labium, that is that separating purpose, this post occipital suture they were responsible. So yesterday already I told you, this is the insect head which bears that appendages like compound eyes, two or three simple eye known as ocelli, facial part, frons, lateral side or cheek region, genu, broad plate-like structure which is present located anteriorly on the frons, which is attached to the frons and labrum, that is clypeus, that is a labrum, upper lip which is freely movable, and then two mandibles, that is this pair of mandibles that is present in insect head, which is also called as teeth of insect. Second pair of jaws, second teeth called as maxillae. And lastly, labium, that is called as the lower lip of insect head. This is all are the appendages and segmentation present in insect head. So student, this is overall our today's topic of this sclerites. Now, let's see in detail the head position. Okay, so give one example. As a human and a cow, as a human and cow, what is the head position of in between two? Try to give answer. Our head position,
hypognathus.
Our and animal. एनिमल का क्या होगा फिर?
नो सर, आवर इज प्रोग्नाथस.
एन एनिमल इज ए हाइपोग्नाथस. सो इन इंसेक्ट बॉडी, इन इंसेक्ट आल्सो, इन डिफरेंट इंसेक्ट आल्सो, देयर आर थ्री मेजर हेड पोजीशन, एंड दिस थ्री हेड पोजीशन आर दिस हाइपोग्नाथस, प्रोग्नाथस, ओपिस्टोग्नाथस. ज्ञाता, ज्ञाता मीन्स माउथ पार्ट. ज्ञाता मीन्स mouth part. Pro, hypo, opisto have the different meaning. Okay, let's see first the hypognathus means what. Hypognathus, this is one which is having the long axis, long axis which is vertical in position of the head, isn't it? And which this long axis of the body, the mouth parts point downwards or below in position. Mouth parts are downwards and below in position, that is called as hypognathus. This type of the hypognathus mouth parts are present in grasshopper, cockroach. In exam, try to give any one example, not required two or three or one, only at least write one example. Okay, now prognathus. Prognathus means what? The insect having the long axis of the head, same long axis of the head, and which is horizontal in nature, and these mouth parts are the directed forward in position. Forward mouth parts are forward in position. This known as a prognathous type of straight forward. The example is like termites, beetle, larvae, that have even also the stick insect, soldier cast of termites. This all are comes under in prognathus, isn't it? Now let's lastly, here not rhynchus, rhynchus not opisthognathus, this is not important. Rhynchus nahi hai, opisthognathus hai. Opisthognathus, the head is reflexed ventrally. Reflexed ventrally. Ventrally means ventral side means what? Ventral side means what? I am
upper side. Upper side.
Upper side.
Again you dis again you no,
lower wrong. Side
lower, lower side
lower side
lower side. How many times I am repeating? Lower. Dorsal. Dorsal means not down. You are confused. Dorsal means upper, means sternum. Ventral means sternum. Lower, lateral, pleuron. Lakshat rahi rata yacha nantar?
Yes sir.
Okay. Which is ventrally, so that mouth parts are directed backwards. ये देखो, ये mouth parts है. Mouth parts are backward. अभी आपके मन में, यानी कि आपके जो दिमाग में एक क्वेश्चन आया होगा, सर किस प्रकार का माउथ पार्ट है? यस और नो? यहाँ पे माउथ पार्ट अलग अलग दिख रहे, यहाँ पे माउथ पार्ट अलग अलग दिख रहे. दीज आर द माउथ पार्ट आर डिफरेंट देन अदर वन, इजंट इट? सो इट्स ए वन प्रोबोसिस. It's a one long proboscis, that needle like structure proboscis, needle like structure proboscis, isn't it? And which is are comes under in only those are the suckers, liquid suckers insect. जिस इंसेक्ट के लिक्विड सकर से उसका माउथ पार्ट्स इस प्रकार होता है और उस माउथ पार्ट्स को हम लोग बोलते हैं दैट इज वी कैन से द ओपिस्टोग्नाथस. इट मींस व्हाट दिस माउथ पार्ट्स दैट वेंट्रली सिचुएटेड दैट मींस द बैकवर्ड एंड विच इज लोकेटेड और दिस माउथ पार्ट्स आर डायरेक्टेड बैकवर्ड इन बिटवीन. नाउ इन बिटवीन द legs, but in between the legs where the legs ka jo part hai coxa, okay, in between the coxa of front legs. Again in your mind, what is coxa? Yes, yes or no?
Yes sir.
What I am talking, the mouth parts of this suckers insect, plant sucker insect, are run backward, isn't it? Run backward in between the coxa of front legs. जो इंसेक्ट के लेग्स रहते कहां पे लेग्स रहता है इंसेक्ट के कौन से रीजन पे इंसेक्ट लेग्स आर सिचुएटेड और लोकेटेड ऑन विच पार्ट ऑफ इंसेक्ट बॉडी
थोरैक्स
ऑन थोरैक्स हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स देयर हाउ मेनी देयर रीजन
थ्री
विच आर दिस
Mesothorax
and
metathorax.
So I'm talking about this between the legs of the front legs. Okay. So legs ke jo part hai, coxa, trochanter, femur, tibia, tarsus, pretarsus, isn't it? So is prakar ke legs ke part hai. Jaise apne isme. Just to take observation on our legs. We have also that thighs and then tibia, isn't it? And then foot, yes or no? Then yes, joint, sir. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Same yes, like sir. Insect having also the different part. The coxa is a first part of insect body, isn't it? Where this mouth parts of this insect body are backward in between the coxa of front legs. So frontal legs, that is called as the forelegs. Hand legs and frontal legs, middle legs, and this hinder legs, that is four legs, middle legs, and hind legs. So this mouth parts are back one in between the coxa of front legs. Uske front legs ko aise connect rehta hai wo. So that is called as the opisthognathus type of mouth parts, isn't it? This is overall. Sir, can you share this record video on group because some network issue? Okay, no problem. I will send. So this is overall the head position about this insect body. Okay, now the next one. Head position here complete. Any doubt about head position?
No, sir.
Okay, now let's see in detail about the. Just I'm enlisting this mouth parts. And then we'll see one by one this all mouth parts because this all mouth parts have you in your practical and theory also. So don't worry, just I'm to enlist and this talking example about this all types of mouth parts. There are the two major functional groups of mouth parts. Some insect have the mandibulate and some insect are haustolate. Mandibulate means what? The insect having the strong mandible, strong teeth, strong sclerized teeth, and insect have without mandibles that having the proboscis, long needle like proboscis that useful for the liquid feeder, that means the sap feeder, and mandibulate for the solid feeder. In mandibulate, chewing and chewing type, that is a dragonfly, damselfly, that is a odonata, termites, isoptera, adult green leaf wing, Neuroptera, beetles, coleoptera, isn't it? And orthoptera, cockroach, blattaria, cockroach. Again, you confuse. Sir, yesterday you talk, cockroaches comes under in dictyoptera. Yes or no? Cockroach comes under in dictyoptera. In dictyoptera, there are two suborder, blattaria and mantodia, isn't it? So cockroach comes under in blattaria order. So orthopteran, catids, crickets, grasshopper and caterpillars, that larva that comes under in lepidoptera. These all are comes under in mandibulate. And the hostulate, that liquid feeder insect or sap feeder insect, primarily you can say, which is used for the sucking liquids and can be broken down into the subgroups stylet and without stylet. Stylet, it is a one needle like structure that be helpful to suck up the juice or sap from the different plant parts, even also in animals also that mosquito were responsible. Okay, so now this is overall the insect mouth parts, labrum, this is the mandible, this is the maxilla, one pair of maxilla, and this is labium, and this is the hypopharynx. Okay, so this all are these insect, those having the chewing and biting type of mouth parts. Now the maxilla, how it look like? Cardosity, pulpiper, pulpy, maxillary pulp, lacinia, gallia, subgallia, these are the parts of maxillary. I'm not explaining because why, we'll see in detail one by one sequentially this all mouth parts. So then during that time I will explain this detail about this all. Then labium, this is the submentum, mentum and prementum, glossa and paraglossa, pulpiger, and having the two, one pair of labial pulp also. Different types of mouth parts are, first chewing and biting type of, that is grasshopper, cockroach, piercing and sucking, plant bugs, mosquito, aphid, jassid, red cotton bug, millibugs, rasping and sucking, this is important for us because it's a odd one, rasping and sucking, example thrips, tala marathi apan phulkide manto, those are the farmers student that they know about the thrips, phulkide manje kay, okay, so that called as the thrips. Sponging, yesterday one girl was asked this question about what is mean by this house plant that doing like behavior, like to touching and on the another like behavior, like about the talking about the hands, but it's not a hand, it's a leg. So it's called as the sponging, it's present in house plant, but it was a good question to ask to clear your ideas, very nice. Now chewing and lapping type of mouth parts that comes under in honeybees only. Siphoning, you know well, the butterflies having the siphon coil like structure, which is a long coiled proboscis, and to its look like our watch. Okay, so it's a coil like, so it's a siphon that is called, is example in butterfly and moths. Mask type, that is a dragonfly and gnats, young one of dragonfly. Degenerate type, that example of maggots of dipteran, this is of the mouth parts of insect. It's look like this figure I am showing you on slide, this is the hemipteran insect, those having the suckers, that having the long coil like structure, sorry, tubular needle like structure, and this is the coil like structure in case of the moth and butterfly. Now the next, see in mosquito, that having the stylet, this one stylet to penetrate in our humans to suck up the blood through this the food canal, because having the stylet of six. And this is the lapping mouth parts, that having the spoon shape flabellum, and this all that mouth parts of chewing and lapping. And this is one same butterfly, and this is a housefly type of sponging type. This is overall, this all modification and different mouth parts of insect body. So student, thank you. So anyone have doubts, so you just to ask me.
Sir, lack insect means?
Yes, yes.
Lack insect.
Masses kara.
Sir, type of mouth parts, three slides.
Type of mouth parts?
Oh.
Where? Which insect? Chat box madhe tak. Yes. Okay. Lac insect means what? Lac insect means it's a scale insect. Lac insect means it is a scale insect. It is also the suckers. Plant sucker insect. Okay. So type of mouth parts divided into two groups. Okay. So two groups means what? Those are the having the solid feeder and those having the or the liquid feeder. Okay. So thank you. I think your the next lecture will start. So this whole video and this today's recording I will send on your group. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.